Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing complex variable type number 4 orthogonal trajectory and we'll solve one problem on it. So friends, till now we are done with the type 1, that is analytic function, type 2 harmonic function, type 3 that is finding analytic function f of z if u is given, v is given, u plus v or u minus v is given. Now we are starting with type 4, that is orthogonal trajectory. So in type 3 we are done with 7 problems. If you still think 7 problems are less, so don't worry friends, type 4 is also same as type 3. We'll see how. Your type 4 is orthogonal trajectory. So friends, what you need to do is, if you are comfortable with the type 3, so whatever is the given problem, you're going to assume it as u and you're going to find it out v by using flowchart number A. So you might be thinking B and C is also applicable here. No, only A will be required. So whatever is the problem, always assume as u and find v by using flowchart A. V is orthogonal trajectory of u. That's it. V is orthogonal trajectory of u. So let's have a look on the problem. Find the orthogonal trajectory of family of curves e raised to minus x cos y plus xy equal to c. So this is the given problem. My aim is to find orthogonal trajectory of family of curves, right? So this is my given problem. I'm going to assume it as u. So let u is equal to, ignore this constant, e raised to minus x cos y plus xy. Just ignore this constant. So instead of c, you can have 2, 3, 4, whatever. Ignore that constant. And remaining problem, you're going to assume it as u. What is next? Same old story. So we're going to find it out ux, uy and so on. U is equal to e raised to minus x cos y plus xy. So let us find it out ux and let me name it as phi 1 x comma y. So which is equal to, when you differentiate with respect to x, you're going to treat y as constant. So cos y is constant. E raised to minus x derivative is minus of e raised to minus x, chain rule. E raised to minus x will remain as it is, into due to minus x, it will be minus 1. Plus, with respect to x, y is constant, x derivative is 1. Phi 1, z comma 0. In place of x, you're going to put z. In place of y, you're going to put 0. Same, there is nothing difference. So this will be, if you put y equal to 0, this will become cos 0 and cos 0 is 1. If you put here minus e raised to minus z, if you put y is equal to 0, this term will be gone. So you'll be left with minus e raised to minus z. Let us find it out uy, that is phi 2 x comma y equal to, with respect to y, x is constant, e raised to minus x is constant, cos y derivative is minus sin y. Plus, with respect to y, x is constant, y derivative is 1. If you put z comma 0, this entire term is 0. Because if you put y as 0, sin 0 is 0, the entire term is 0. You will be left with only this term, that is z, because in place of x I'm going to put z. What next? Empty. By empty, f dash z is equal to phi 1 z comma 0 minus I times phi 2 z comma 0. Phi 1 z comma 0, we got it as minus e raised to minus z minus I times phi 2 z comma 0, that is z. So this is our f dash of z. What next? Integrate. Same old story, nothing new. integrate. So what is f of z? Minus constant e raised to minus z upon minus 1. This minus will remain as it is, and e raised to minus z integration is e raised to minus z upon minus 1 minus I times z square upon 2 plus c. So the finally f of z is e raised to minus z minus I by 2 z square plus c. Friends, this is not yet done. My aim is to find orthogonal trajectory, and as discussed, use orthogonal trajectory is v. So basically we need to find it out v. For doing that, you need to separate u and v. For that purpose, you know, we're going to write it down f of z as u plus iv, this z as x plus iy, minus I by 2, this z is x plus iy, the whole square plus c. Let us simplify it. The first term can be written as e raised to minus x, e raised to minus iy. Because if you multiply these two terms, you will get this. Your indices will be added. This minus will be multiplied inside. Minus I by 2, let us open the bracket, a plus b the whole square. What is the formula? A square plus 2ab plus b square plus c. Let's further simplify it. This is e raised to minus x, then we have e raised to minus iy. E raised to minus iy is cos y minus I times sin y. That is the formula. E raised to minus I theta is cos theta minus I sin theta. The same formula. E raised to minus iy is cos y minus I times sin y. Then we have, let us multiply this minus I by 2 inside bracket. So that will be minus I by 2 into x square. Next, multiply to this. So here, this I and this I is I square, and I square value is minus 1. But here it is minus 1. So minus minus will become plus. This 2 and this 2 will be cancelled. So in short, you will be left with xy only. Next, this I square is minus 1. So this minus 1 and this outside minus will become plus 1, will be left with I. So basically plus I y square plus c. So friends, you need to be very careful while opening the brackets. So if this goes inside, you will get e raised to minus x cos y minus I e raised to minus x sin y minus I by 2 x square. And friends, this 2 multiplied here, so we'll be left with this 2. So here it will be 2. So that will be xy plus I y square upon 2 plus c. Let us separate real and imaginary part. E raised to minus x cos y is real. This is also real. If you take plus I outside, here you will get minus e raised to minus x sin y. Here you will get minus x square by 2. And here you will get, since you have taken plus I outside, you will be left with y square upon 2. So this is your u plus iv. If you equate, u is equal to e raised to minus x cos y plus xy, and v is minus e raised to minus x sin y minus x square by 2 plus y square by 2. So you need to compare u with the given problem. U is correct, so obviously v is also correct. And as we discussed, v is orthogonal trajectory of u. That's it. So friends, if you refer books or watch other videos or in college, this topic is very complicatedly explained to you. So don't worry, you can follow this simple trick. Remember type 3 and type 4. What is the difference? Nothing. You're going to assume the problem as u and just find v by using the flowchart. So in type 3, we solved 4 problems in which we assume the problem as u. Right. So all of the 4 problems can be asked in orthogonal trajectory also. If you remember the first problem of type 3, it was e raised to x cos y. So that problem can come in this type also, asking find the orthogonal trajectory of family of curves e raised to x cos y is equal to c. So what are you going to do? Assume it as u. So u is equal to e raised to x cos y. Follow the same procedure, same example, and you will get the value of v, that is orthogonal trajectory. So out of 4 problems, any problem can be asked to find orthogonal trajectory. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll see one more example on orthogonal trajectory.